do they call it the open house?
Well,
is that the
it's
name
a church
of
it? Thing.
Oh.
It's a church thing. A. Kozel married Mr. O'Brien, and they went to the St. John's Lutheran Church in Hudson, which closed. It was one of the saddest videotapes I ever made. I called
the
it
church
Requiem,
closed?
A Requiem for Church.
Isn't that awful?
And they combined with another church in Hudson. And she's a Kozel, and it's her brother who owns a restaurant. And for some reason, they're having an open house today. And their open houses are fantastic.
Well, they don't do it all that often?
But when,
well, isn't my timing good then?
And so when St. John's merged with Emmanuel Lutheran in Hudson, they had a party for us, and that was 2-3 years ago.
Wow.
And it's right down on 9H. You probably went by it many times.
I guess.
And all right, let's find out if Kirk is going, because he said he'd go if it was a good day, and he would go with me. Kirk K. I. Here he is. This is, by the way, the best of them all. No contract, $30 a month. 1,000 calls and 1,000 messages.
Wow.
1,000 texts, 1,000 calls, $30 a month. And I hand in 4 or 5 hours a month I don't use. And the instrument
what plan is
it? It's Straight Talk, it's Walmart.
Boy, that's cheap.
Well, I think it is. It's a Walmart thing. You have to get it only at Walmart.
Boy, that's tremendous. Nobody home?
Kirk! Kirk, it's Glendora. Kirk, it's Glendora.
Hi, how are you?
Good, are you feeling better?
No, about the same.
Oh, I think you ought to come up and go with us to the open house.
Where?
To the open house.
Who's going?
My friend Bruce. He was
He
was our neighbor in Stanfordville, Franklin, and he was a neighbor of Franklin and myself.
Oh.
And he and I are going.
Oh, you are going?
Yes, and I want you to go. It'll do your cold good. Did you eat hot cereal this morning, Kirk?
No.
See?
No.
See, you've got to do those things.
Yeah.
Did you eat orange juice?
No.
So why don't you go up there and meet us? And Kirk and I and Bruce and I will meet you in his Mercedes-Benz.
What time are you leaving?
Right now.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, because we're going. Oh, and Kirk, I got the best news for you. Gregory Washburn was up here yesterday from Poughkeepsie, and he gave you about 20 VHS tapes.
How many?
20. 17, 18, 19, 20. They're all yours. I'll take them
over.
I'll take them to Kozel's, and if you come up, you can have them.
All right. I'll see if I can make it.
That's a good boy. So I'll
all
see.
Right.
Yeah, I'll see. And Bruce and I are going to feed the cows on our way over.
All right.
And yesterday, Kirk, when we came home from Hartford, Connecticut, I stopped at Price Chopper, and I bought them $19 worth of apples. And Kirk, when I went up to the cow started to walk toward me.
Oh, yeah, that's good. That's great.
The one with
well, they love you, Glendora.
The one with the white face, he walked.
Yeah,
He came within 3 feet of the electric fence, and I was on 3 feet the other side, and I was able to toss the apples right to him. And he looked so happy. I gave him 6, so I'm going to give him 6 more today.
Oh, okay.
All right, sweetie. I'll see you at Kozel's.
Your show was great last night. I loved it.
Really? Tell me about
it. Your show was on TV last night.
That's the boy. You made him do it. And were you in it?
Yeah. You put my voice on the recording. again recorded when I called you.
Really? Oh, that's...
Yeah, it was about you. You were doing your exercises.
Jumping jacks?
I can do jumping jacks.
You did a wonderful good dog.
Oh, thank you, Kirk. Good for you, honey. Did you go to church this morning?
No, I didn't make it. It was way too cold.
It certainly was. It was 9 degrees.
No, it was terrible.
Yes.
It was way down in Hudson.
Okay, honey.
So it was colder than that. I think it was like 6 above in Hudson.
Okay, dress up and wear your black suit and your black tie, okay?
All righty.
Because Bruce is all dressed up, okay, sweetie?
All right.
All right. I'll see you there.
What's it about? Do you know what it's about?
No, I don't.
You don't?
But I don't care.
How much is going to get in? How much is they charge to get in?
It's an open house, honey. I don't think they're going to charge anything, but if they do, we're prepared to pay for it.
Oh, I got some money on me.
You don't have to. I'll take care of you.
No,
I'll bring you those tapes, and would you like that package of 6 tapes that you thought were so nice because they were brand new? Would you like those also?
Which ones?
Well, you found, when you were doing the tapes for me, you found a package of 6 VHS that hadn't been opened.
Yeah.
Do you want them? I'll give them.
Sure, if you can save them, if you can, you gotta use them, you go ahead and use them, but...
No, I'll give them to you. I'll give them to you.
You've got, what, 20?
Yeah, you've got about 26 now.
Oh, my God. What are you going to do with 26?
Whatever you want.
Are they all brand new?
No, just 6 of them.
Oh, okay.
But the others have only one pass on them, and they're very interesting programs that were taped by somebody, and Greg bought them at a flea market. The man wanted to get rid of them. In fact, he got them free. The man just wanted to get rid of them.
Oh, I see.
I'm going to bring them to you, honey. I'll see you at Kozel's.
All right, I'll try to be there.
All right. Bye-bye.
I might not get there to 2.
Okay. Do the best you can.
All right.
Yeah, do the best you can.
All right. See you later. Bye-bye.
Okay.
Sounds like a character.
He has some kind of a disability, and I don't know what it is. Huh. And he's on...
His voice sounded kind of...
Yeah,
scratchy.
He's... he has a cold. But that's where I met him. He was the sexton at St. John's,
oh.
And he was the one who went up and put out the candles for the last time. And he walked down the aisle, and I swear he was crying. We were all crying. Yeah. Okay. Now... those are going to be safe in your car?
Oh, yeah.
All right. Here's the tapes that he wanted. Okay?
Just these?
Yeah, it's only 5. Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
Is that going to fall off? That doesn't look balanced. I'm afraid they're going to fall. Might be better just on the floor.
What's that phone saying? Or is that your phone?
Nope. Not
okay,
mine.
In that top drawer, there's a bag. And would you put, and see the ones that are in the crate, Bruce? Will you put them all in a bag for him? And I'll get the apples.
I don't think they're all going to fit.
Oh, okay, then you want to take the crate?
No. They might fit.
I mean, it looks like it'll fit.
What are these tapes of?
Well, they're interesting. They're movies. They're specials on TV.
Oh.
They are... this, whoever this woman was...
Oh, yeah?
Did a very good job.
The cat loves laying right next to the heat here.
Oh, really? And I think this cat's ready to come in.
There, I doubled the bag, so it should be okay.
Amadeus! Oh, look at him come in, Bruce. Look at him come in.
It's cold out there.
Bless his heart. You got enough to eat, honey? Now, Bruce, here are their apples. Are there 6 in there, honey? I'll have to go a little gross and I'll be right with you.
7.
Okay.
You pretty. Yes, you're a pretty kitty.
Poor Harry.
You're a pretty kitty cat.
Now the road is dry where we're going. We've got to go over the cornfield road, and I know you thought it was terrible when your Mustang went over it.
Well, the car is plenty dirty, so it doesn't matter.
It is dirty.
The beautiful thing is it's silver, and it cleans very easily.
Oh, it does?
The black shows. It's so hard to keep black clean.
Well, you always did.
But silver is a dream.
You and Clarence always did.
Yeah. In fact, Mom and Dad's car is a 1992, and the finish on it's still beautiful. That's Penny's car. Let's go for a ride with Penny's car.
She goes for a ride?
She loves. We went up to a place near Monticello, where I think I've told you in the past there's a bald eagle.
It's going.
Okay. Another one. It only comes through. Oh, yeah. center comes from Mercedes, Germany.
door and stand for the president. Mark has been better this year about the weather because there's been so much snow. But I still, when I come back after the show, I think I'm not going to stand. This is teaser. right in the snow. it okay to give it to Harriet? And he said, yes. It's a $25 bag.
I think I got you.
a huge New York Yankee fan. So we invited over to watch game with him. And I've been promising her I would take her to New York City. So she and I both love the Yankees. But we also love the Broadway show band in the Bay Area. It's a tremendous music band. So last week I took her down and took her to a rooftop restaurant on the 48th floor. Thank you. they said it's going to be mandatory.
Thank you. Thank you.
show what works the best. It's real wide and flat and has a very straight edge on the top. In a blacktop, you want to get a great down to the bare. You don't want to have a packed surface. That's what I was afraid of with this last year.
I'm be here. We'll bring a picture.
Take your time.
The restroom, so here's your back. I'll leave it right here for a minute. Be right back.
All right, Katie.
Which isn't true. Not related. No. Hasn't seen or heard of it. Table 12. Appreciate you saving me a seat. It's okay, pal. That's all right. Hey, listen, don't say nothing. Table 12. You get here before me, boom, no seats.
Table 12.
I thought they were ready from heaven.
Well.
Get it.
Okay. All right.
Sure.
Thank you.
Sure, I bet you haven't seen
I'll come back and get
while.
This stuff.
Yeah, I'll bring it out when I come.
Keep eye on it.
So it was just nice visiting him, and I got in the other one. It wasn't this one.
Nice seeing you. Nice seeing you.
Yeah.
Buffy.
Buffy.
Could not think of that. I was calling her everything else.
You want to go to the mailbox? Look at this. Look at this, folks. Cover. Frozen. What am I going to do with it? Come on, we're going to the mailbox. Yeah, come on. Come on. You get cabin fever, huh? Amadeus. You have cabin fever, right? Yeah. Yeah, you want to go for a walk. All right. We'll go for a walk. This way. Road's dry, folks. There. Come on, Amadeus.
He just wanted to go for a walk. That's all. He was tired of staying in the house. He wants to play. An apple. Too bad. A Granny Smith. I dropped it. Or Kirk dropped it. Oh, you ready to go in the house now? Okay. We'll go in the house now. Yep, he's had enough. Let's see what the temperature is. It's sunny. Is 8 degrees. What do you read it as? Yes, I'll let you in just a minute. Yeah, 8 degrees. Okay. Okay, here's the door open for you. Good, I'm glad you had your walk and your exercise. Back into the cozy little house in the home theater. I'm just going to see if I can stay out there long enough. Cover off of that car. Maybe someday it'll warm up.
Failure. Double failure, folks. What is success?
Getting them to run. Success with Amadeus going to the mailbox. Thank you, Glendora. This is from the wife of the Reverend James Slater, pastor of St. Luke's Lutheran Church in Palatia. Dear Glendora, thank you for the card-making kit. I saw it at Oddlot. It was an impulse buy. I love making my own cards for people. I'll still have to play with it a lot to get it to print on the card. This is kind of pretty good. I never seen Glendora spelt with two R's. But it makes for nice possibilities. Thank you also for my happy book. She asked for one. I'm happy to have my second snow day to catch up on some of my school and home projects. Hope you are staying warm this winter. Blessings, Krista. Thank you. Folks, here's a nice letter from Mary Ramage in Mohegan Lake. See how nicely she writes for age 79. She had the cataracts removed. She's getting new glasses. And she loves .com. She sits at the TV and watches and waits to see .com. And .com will not turn her pretty little face toward Mary so Mary can see it. Good for you, Mary Ramage, Mohegan Lake, Cablevision, Yorktown.
Cat.
I have some information for you, and they want me to send them something, and I want to know if they should. Please give me a call. Thanks, and I hope you're feeling all right. I'm worried about you, because it's not right you have to call back. Talk to you later. Bye.
Message deleted. Message two.
Hi, Glendora. Enjoy the system calling. If you got a minute, give me a call. 610-8056. Thanks, dear.
Message deleted. Message three.
Hey, Miss Glendora, Charles.
Charles Clampett, Long Island. Long Island, Brooklyn, and Kinderhook.
Message deleted. Last message.
That's a blank.
calling you on Saturday. I think it's about 10:30 a.m. I got all your messages. Thank you. Give me a call back when you can. I wanted to let you know that yesterday I sent you one of the phones in the mail. So you should be getting that hopefully in the next couple days. I mailed it out yesterday about 12:30. Okay, talk to you soon. Bye.
Press 3 for advanced options. Press 5 to repeat the current message. Press message deleted. Message 2. Received. Sunday, January 16th, 1:13 p.m.
Hi, Glendora, this is Kirk. Just giving you a message. I'll pick you up at noontime tomorrow because we're invited out to Millfields for the dinner. You can call me at...
Message deleted. Message 3. Received. Monday, January 17th, 12:47 p.m.
Hi, Glendora. It's Rick at Time Warner in Buffalo, New York. Returning your call. Everything is good up here. Show's airing as scheduled. And I get your disc all the time, so we're in good shape. So I'll talk to you soon. Bye.
Thanks, Rick.
Four for the message. Message deleted. Message 4. Received. Monday, January 17th, 12:50 p.m.
Glendora, it's 12:50 on Monday. It's Kathleen Hagedish, and I just called to tell you I'm still watching your show, your shows, and I just want to know how you're doing and how the dog is doing, and I see all the cats are eating well, but you got big kibble bills. So I'm just thinking about you now. I'm doing better, and I just want you know I'm still watching the show, and I love you. Take care. Bye-bye.
Thank you, Kathleen.
Message deleted. Message 5. Received. Wednesday, 5:07 p.m.
Hello, Glendora. This is Alan from Lawrence Public Access. You have a show for us. As you keep trying to put on, and we haven't been going on here due to paperwork. We just need you to sign a piece of paperwork saying this is your contact information and all that. We also need you to have a guarantor from Wallingford, someone that's from Wallingford that says it's okay for this, that they want this to go on the air. You can give me a call back here at the studio at 203-294-9722. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Alan Billings.
Press 4 for the previous message. Press 3 for advanced options. Prep message deleted. Message 6. Received. Thursday, 7:31 p.m.
Hi, Glendora. This is Kirk at home. Okay, I guess home. Okay. This is Kirk. Please say that receipt.
Sure.
Receipt from Walmart today.
Yep.
When I picked up your card and...
Message deleted. Message 7. Received. Friday, 2:50 p.m.
Hi, Glendora. George calling. If you got a minute, give me a call. 610-8056. Okay, George. Adios.
George Dixon.
Press 4 for the previous message. Put message deleted. Message 8. Received. Friday, 3:09. P.M.
Hi, Glendora. It's Jackie. If you can, give me a call back, please. I need your permission to do something. Okay, sweetheart? Because Big Cat called me. If you can, give me a call back. Bye.
Press 4 for the previous message deleted. Message 9. Received. Friday, 4:42 p.m.
Glendora, this is Bob Levitt. It's about 4:45 Friday afternoon. I'm returning your call from earlier. Sorry I haven't gotten back sooner. Yesterday I was enjoying some of the snow that we have. I'm going skiing.
He's from New Hampshire.
Returning your call again. That's Bob Levitt. Area code 203-438-8099.
was that?
Press 4 for the previous message. First, message received.
No.
Saturday,
not
January, message 2. Received message 4. Received message 5. Received message 6. Message 7. Received Friday message 8. Received message 9. Received Friday 4:42 p.m.
Glendora, this is Bob Lynn. It's about 4:45 Friday afternoon. I'm returning your call from earlier. Sorry I haven't gotten back sooner. Yesterday I was enjoying some of the snow that we have. I've gone skiing. Anyway, returning your call again. That's Bob Lynn. Area code 203-438-8093. Take care now.
8093.
Press 4 for the previous message. Message deleted. Last message received Friday 5:47 p.m.
Hi, Glendora. This is Kirk. Give me a call and checking on you, see if you're okay. You can call me if you like. 657. My number is.
It's got a new number.
The number is 653-4607.
Medicare gave him that telephone, or Medicaid or something. Gave him a
press 4
mobile
for the
phone.
Previous message. 3. Message deleted. No more messages. Press 4 for the previous message. Press 3.
Okay, that's magic, Jack. They look intelligent. They look so intelligent. What? The dog.
Or is it a fox? A fox is like a dog.
Jackie may be moving from Brooklyn to Long Island, folks. The rent on her apartment has gone up to $1,700. $1,700. Ocean Parkway, Brooklyn, $1,700. She's been there 35 years. The rent was $200. But Benny, her dog, would have a whole fenced-in yard to run in. And her bird, who is something like 30 years old. Her parrot, I believe he's 30 years old. He flies all around the house. Now he'd like it, it's a 3-bedroom. Wow, and it's in Long Island, it's in Commack. It's Suffolk County. So, but her son can sign for my Brooklyn show. And it won't come up again until next year. Brooklyn's BCAT has promised me, Brooklyn Community Access Television has promised me, that by March, Devin will be able to put my program into the computer and send it to them electronically, the same way email goes. But then they promised me that for the year 2010 in March also. It's interesting, isn't it? Life is interesting. Her daughter is a lieutenant in the Brooklyn Police Department.
Yes,
that's very nice. Okay, what we will do is open your hood, sweetie.
Okay.
Let me see if this is going to work.
Where the wire reach, that's what I'm wondering. Where the wire reach.
Oh, yeah.
Huh?
I'm not using that. I'm using my
pieces. Oh, how long are they?
Very long.
Are they?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so that means I got to start the car up.
No, let me see the hood first.
Huh?
How nice your car looks.
I know.
Let me see, open the hood first.
All right.
You got it all polished up. It looks lovely.
No, I don't. Been through the car wash yet. Let me do that, because it's tricky to do it.
How are you?
Good, young boy.
You a good boy, are you?
Yeah.
You a good boy?
Yeah, I think so. You know what I mean? Hi, guys. Goes in here. It was a running engine, huh?
Mm.
Yep. That's what it looks like.
Okay.
And it's got a cap over it.
All right, just take your cap off.
How you do that?
Yeah, just take it
oh,
off.
Oh, like that?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
And then we'll put the red clamp on here. That's the positive terminal.
Okay.
And we'll put the black clamp on there.
All right, but I'll start the car because I don't want... Yeah.
No, don't start until you get it hooked up.
Oh, okay. Oh, okay. All righty. You know what you're doing.
Yeah.
I don't want to drain the battery. I just hope I don't kill my battery, you know, drain my battery.
No. No. Amazing thing. Look at that. You see how it just opened
the top? Yeah. Oh my God, they are long. Oh my God. Oh my God, Glendora. Put the bag in there.
No, let me show you.
You gotta put the bag in there.
No, I don't put it in.
Okay.
Watch.
Oh. Oh. Okay. Oops.
Don't ever touch it, would you?
Okay. Okay.
Okay, sweet.
Now what?
I'll show you. Don't let these touch now once they're connected.
Yeah, I know. Tell me about it.
Oh, you do know that?
I know about that part, yeah, but I don't
know. All right, I'll keep these separate. Wait a minute.
Okay.
Let me keep this separate.
Okay. Is this long enough? But that'll go way over there?
Oh, yes, I think so.
I don't think so. I might have to turn my car around, Glendora.
All right, wait a minute. I'll tell you.
You might have to. Looks like I might have to. Did you shut that off?
Yes, I did right now.
You have to shut that off. You don't want to get electrocuted.
There it is, it's off. And?
Try your boofers. Right there. I ain't got mine touching. I don't think they're gonna reach. I doubt it.
Keep going over.